how did my life get to this point? To be honest, I felt like this was a long time coming. It's safe to say my life's always been a mess. I grew up a pretty normal kid, only child, nice house, parents that loved me, but one day that all changed. This piece of shit broke into our house. He must have not been expecting my dad to be home, and that was it. He left like nothing had happened. No idea the daughter of the man he just killed was watching it all from the closet. I had a knife, I know I could have stopped him, but I just froze. What do you think something like that does to a kid? My mom took it even worse. I'll never forget the night I lost her. He stared right at me and just gave her his poison like she was just another client. Not the mother of a little girl who just lost her father. She died a few hours later, overdose. From that night on, I was just a shell of what you'd call a person. And although I just seem like another face in the crowd, I'm simply not here. I always thought back to that moment, what I could have done, what I should have done. But I wasn't strong enough, so he had to do it for me.
I'm here at the scene where police have just identified the body of William Huey, who appears to be the victim of a grisly murder. An apparent note left at the scene indicates the crime was committed by someone calling himself the Grinning Man. Police suspect that Huey may not be the first victim to be killed by the murderer, who is currently at large.
The Grinning Man. He was a serial killer. He took 34 more lives over the course of 3 years. But nothing lasts forever. It was Halloween night at 251 East Street, and a man named Liam Fogleboch was about to be paid a visit.
You're seriously just gonna do fake blood?
Well, what am I supposed to do? Glue red cotton balls to my face? I can't do makeup for shit.
Could he use the mask?
Well, Freddy talks too much, and it would be shitty if my mouth wasn't moving.
Fuck!
What's with you, man? You've been jittery as hell since I got here.
What are you talking about? It's nothing.
Well, someone's at the door, bro. Aren't you gonna get it?
Yeah, you're right.
Hey, Jay. Happy Halloween. Dig the cake.
Thank you.
It's my favorite time of year.
Mine as well, man.
You can tell you decorated the shit out of this place.
Oh, yeah, dude. I don't want to be boring. Anyways, what brings you here?
Let's hear your collect rent.
Oh, there you go.
Thank you.
So, you got any plans tonight?
Nothing big. I think we're just gonna chill here. Hand out some candy, maybe scare some kids.
Should come down to the club after. We have a big party going on. Get your VIP seating.
I'd love to, but not tonight.
Maybe some other time, though. Anyways, how's business going?
Great. My eye's performing. That doesn't smell like tobacco. Liam, you signed the lease. You know I don't have drugs at my properties.
It's mine. I'm sorry. I was gonna smoke it outside.
Well, have a good day.
Fuck!
Hey, we didn't know the landlord was coming by.
So, are you just scared of him, or...?
No, it's not that, it's just... I don't know, man.
What is it, dude?
I think Ari's cheating on me.
Shit, dude. That's fucked. Do you know who with?
I mean, you know who's taking her home.
Are you serious?
I guess we're about to find out. Hi.
What's up? You okay?
I hope you know you're not coming in.
What?
After that shit you just pulled? Come on.
What are you talking about?
Don't fucking lie to me.
Babe, I didn't do anything.
I was with her all night. She didn't do anything.
You know what? I can't look it out of my Both of you should just fucking
leave. But you were our ride home.
It's not my fucking problem.
I don't see you guys coming back from that one.
Fuck her, bro.
So, you think it's over?
Honestly, yeah, it might be. That sucks. You guys were really good together for a while there. Yeah, I know. I just can't deal with the shit from him anymore.
There's a bus station around the block.
Do they run this late? And how long is this block? I don't want to waste time on it if it's not a definite thing.
Hey, let me look at this. It's a straight shot.
I don't like that.
I'm going. Haley, wait!
Hey babe, how's it going? Yeah, trick-or-treating just ended, and I'm so happy to get that paint off my face. Yeah. Yeah, Frank and Susie just went down to that party at Red Handed. Oh, yeah, I'm just watching Halloween with Liam right now. He's not really having the best night. Oh, you want me to come down afterwards? Yeah, I can do that. Alright, cool. I'll see you soon.
Expecting me. Life's full of surprises, ain't it?
You know, I've been considering retiring the grinning man for a while,
and your bitch girlfriend shooting me really helped me decide that. Her friend's dead, but she got away. Don't worry, I'll get her back. She ruined one of my favorite suits after all. Good thing I always keep a spare. Oh, Liam, don't look at me like that. You're breaking my heart. Look at the bright side. I've left you a couple gifts. We've got your mask, a bag of your belongings, and your machete is in your friend's head out front. Well, at least he put up a good fight. You know, you really were the perfect fall guy. Very few acquaintances aside from your small group of friends, history of getting in fights. Don't you love it when a plan comes together? Now we match. You know, you really should be happy. You're gonna be famous. Grinning man.
Thank you.
Everything he did, all the bloodshed, none of it mattered, because he did the one thing I could never do, and, well, I guess I owed him.
How did this happen? Well, it was your typical day at the office. The internet was down, there were no cases to crack, so I was coping the way I usually do.
Look at you, party animal.
What?
What? It's like 4 o'clock.
I'm pre-gaming it.
Not on work hours, you're not.
Then find me some actual work to do so I don't have to play crappy Flash games so I pretend to actually do stuff.
Fair.
Wayne Truman, 44. Slick brown hair, brown eyes. A private investigator and former hero cop. Forced to retire during his prime when a drug dealer killed his nephew over a turf dispute. And he took the law into his own hands.
You used to know Nick Truman, right?
Yeah? Why?
And his uncle.
He didn't go through with it, but he had to turn in his badge and gun for beating the guy. He's a damn good investigator. Not too cool under stress. Well, not since he lost the love of his life a year ago, the victim of a serial killer. He hasn't taken it well. He's probably the closest thing I've ever had to a father since Dad, and I'm kind of his only friend anymore. Well, other than his dog.
So what are you pre-gaming for anyways?
Wayne, you're old.
What?
But if you must know, I'm seeing him tonight.
You know I'm gonna get it out of you eventually.
I'll give you a hint. He's a bit of a celebrity.
Alright. A celebrity you've been dating for the past month.
2 months today, actually.
So, 2 months. And somehow I haven't seen any photos of you and him together in the papers? So he's not an actor, nothing TV heavy.
Correct.
Give me another hint. What's he known for?
Property.
The nightclub guy? Seriously?
Not to brag, but he owns a lot more than that. And he owns the ghost house on East Street, too.
So should I do some digging, then?
Oh, please. Find us a real case to work on, will ya?
So, dinner's in a couple of hours.
Mind if I clock out a few minutes early to get ready?
Yeah, sure can. Go have fun. Just be careful.
I got this.
Oh. Hey, and I heard his club's got pretty good steak. Be much obliged if you bring me one back.
Bye, Wayne.
Hey, hold up. I know it might seem like bad timing with your big date tonight and all, but got this for you.
Why do I need this?
Never know when you're gonna need one. Besides, I like knowing you're protected.
Thanks, Wayne.
You know, I am gonna need $5 for that.
Have a good night.
I'm serious. Taking it out of your paycheck.
So, welcome back to another issue, everybody.
So here we are at the site of the legendary Grinning Man's torture chamber.
After killing 35 people, Liam Fogleboch was nearly taken out by a would-be victim.
Hey, jackass!
My God. Anyway, he must have thought another close call wouldn't have been worth it because he killed himself shortly afterward in his apartment. And the rest, as they say, is history.
Although that apartment on East Street is now vacant, I've located another piece of Grinning Man history.
Get the fuck open. Okay. This one's locked. We're gonna try another entrance. Okay. We got a window right here. Let's see if we can try this out. Okay, this... Come on! Ugh. All right, this might not work. All right, let's see if we can try something else. All right, so it looks like we are out of options because that window's not working. I'm just gonna try opening the same door that I tried to open earlier. It's probably not going to work, but in the off chance that it
Oh, look at that. All right, yeah, we're going inside this bitch.
All right, guys, I'm not gonna lie. I'm getting really nervous about this. Just check around these corners. So where we're at is the Cooley Printing Press. It's been abandoned since 2005. Or, well, I hope abandoned. Let me check around these corners. So yeah, this is the very same spot where Grinning Man tortured and killed at least 10 of his victims, mutilating them all. Some residents say you can still hear the screaming. Well, let's see if this apartment is the only place with a ghost story. Oh!
Officer Hudson, I have a small favor that I must ask of you.
Mike Hudson, 26. Black hair, green eyes, tall, bulky figure. Psychopathy incarnate with a massive ego to match. A legend at the police force, he's responsible for taking down 5 different serial killers, his most recent kill being the infamous Whiteface killer. Tragically, he lost his partner in the chase. He was recently put on paid leave for what the EPD claims is a grieving period. Who could have possibly guessed what he was really up to? Little did Mike know, his vacation was about to come to an end.
What is it?
Is there something wrong on my end? You're awfully quiet.
No, sorry. Just put Jade to sleep. Let's do any use of this whole parenting thing.
Okay. I'll make this quick then. I know it's last minute, but we just got a call from the station earlier requesting your presence at a funeral viewing tomorrow for one of the Whiteface killer's victims. I normally wouldn't ask you to do something like this, but this is the brother of one of the station's biggest donors.
You don't mean...
So, Officer Symmens, having finally found the time to mull over the Hudson report you left for me, I've noticed certain... discrepancies.
I can't risk divulging certain things. Not only could I lose my job, but I could also get a lot of heavy...
Bullshit!
Joseph Grant, prefers Jay. 25, matte black hair, blue eyes, distinctive wardrobe. Borderline split personality, well, bipolar at the very least. He runs the hottest club in town, red-handed. By day, he's a local celebrity and philanthropist, and by night, well, he's a loan shark. His twin brother was the final victim of hero cop Mike Hudson's latest trophy kill, the Whiteface Killer. That was a story anyhow, and Jay wasn't buying.
Hands.
You got me fucked up. Think I'll just...
Either you give me your hands or I have my friend Cedric out there beat you within an inch of your life and then I get your hands anyway. I guess it's your call. You know, I thought you were my friend, officer. But then you gave me that useless report on Hudson. Now I have to do all the digging myself!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, it won't happen again.
For your sake, I hope that's the truth. You know, you're not the only one at the force who answers to me.
Symmens, we need you to respond to a noise complaint on state.
Noise complaint call. Sounds serious. You should probably respond to that. Get the fuck out of here.
Hey, boss, your date is here. Right this way, miss.
Well?
Tomorrow's the big day. I think I've got Hudson figured out.
He's definitely not who he claims to be.
To be fair, if that pig with his tail between his legs is any indication, neither are we.
Look at you!
Am I pretty enough?
Even if you didn't get all dolled up, you would be.
Well, you should know. Subtlety isn't my strong suit.
Something we have in common. So, any new cases lately? Are you planning an expose on me?
Of course not. It's almost all obsessed wives having us follow their husband around to see if they're having an affair.
Well, are they usually?
More often than not. Just think, if you're crazy enough to have a PI spy on you, wouldn't you do anything to get away?
Well, when you're me, crazy people trying to get your attention are just par for the course.
What does that say about me?
You are a welcome change of pace.
You never know. I could be another psycho fan and I just happen to be hot.
Trust me, I know the type. You do not fit the description.
I'm getting real tired of these stupid-ass anonymous noise complaint calls.
Tell me about it, man.
Whole lot of nothing.
Let's go check it out and get out of here.
Yeah.
Hey, Symmens, check this out.
Fucking vandals.
I think we found the source of our noise complaint.
Yeah? Let's check it out. It's been years since I've been here.
Case, right?
Yeah, I prefer not to talk too much about it.
Understood. Shit like that fucks with your head, man.
10 years of sleepless nights. Daily flashbacks to the crime scene. I don't know what I was thinking taking that case. I'll check right, you check left.
Gotcha.
No!
Hudson, we just received a call. I'm still being updated by officers on the scene, but I think I have another case for you.
I thought we were done with this.
What is it, Chief?
The station. They're saying it's the Grinning Man.
Well, tonight was great.
Yeah, it was.
I was gonna say have a good drive home, but I should probably be taking you.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? Gonna get me in the car and do unspeakable things to me?
What? No, I'm never.
I'm just kidding. Thank you for taking me home.
Let's get you.
Oh, hi.
Here's your keys.
Thank you. You work for Jay, right? Michael?
Nico, actually.
Right. Sorry, I just woke up. Do you need a ride?
No, Cedric's about a block away. You've got some stuff to take care of.
Can I assume your being late means that you sealed the deal last night?
I was too drunk. Jay had to give me a ride home.
Oh, so we're calling him Jay now.
I am. Honestly, I'll be lucky if I ever hear from him again.
See, I told you to take it easy, but you are just hell-bent on learning lessons the hard way.
I know. At least he was nice enough to drop my car off this morning so I didn't have to pick it up and be even more late. So you can thank him. I even showed up when I did. And you can thank him for this. They brought this for you. I forgot. He didn't.
Maybe I will have to thank him.
Oh, what do you got?
Well, while you were dealing with the warning consequences of pre-gaming, I was catching up on the news. Check it out.
The Grinning Man's back. I hope this means we get to keep the lights on.
Wonder what that could be. Well, this should be interesting.
Maryanne Fogleboch.
Ma'am, wait, did you say,
I know what you're thinking. The crazy old bitch can't accept facts. Jeffrey Dahmer, Ted Bundy. Did you know that people are comparing my boy to guys like that?
Well, he did kill 37 people. What? It's true.
No, he didn't. He was a good boy.
Ma'am, pardon me for rushing you, but why is it that you called us?
The Green Man is back. Don't you see? Liam is innocent, and you can prove it.
Okay, and how would we do that?
By finding the real killer.
Mrs. Fogleboch, I don't think we...
You can do it. I trust you.
It's just a bit bigger.
I've got $10,000. I can give you a check for half of it right now. Please do this for me. Even evidence will do. What about his landlord, Joseph something?
Actually, he was cleared of any wrongdoing.
Well, it could have been anybody. I'm just trying to get you guys to push
forward. Hey! What did I tell you about spending our money on dumb shit? You raised a serial killer. Get the fuck over it!
Please?
Now!
Hey, you all right?
I'm fine.
I know. Look, you don't have to do this if you don't want to.
I want to, I just... Can you do this part without me from now on?
Absolutely.
And I'm leaving Jay out of it.
Come on. Why don't you head back to your place, rest for a bit.
I just told you, yes, I will have it done. Alright, I have to go. Who the hell are you supposed to be?
What's it to you? This is a public chapel, you know.
Hudson, right?
Yeah.
Go right on in.
Thank you.
Pleasure to meet you, Officer Mike Hudson.
So much potential in him. You know, they say twins have a special connection. Thank you for your service, Officer Hudson.
Of course, and I'm sorry about your brother.
He was the only family I had. Now I know you two had a history together, but just know that I hold no ill will towards you, Mike.
Though the rest were never anything personal. I was only doing my job.
You know, he actually did start to get clean towards the end there. Now, he picked up other vices, but I was proud of him.
Do you have any family?
Two kids. I got partial custody on one, still fighting for the other.
Don't give up, Mike.
Pretty empty in here. When did everyone else show up?
I didn't invite anybody else.
What?
Now, for why I really brought you here.
And why is that?
I know what you did, Mike. I know you're a murderer.
If that's so, why even bother bringing me here?
Well? Hey, I think you better tone it down.
No, Cedric. Our friend Mike here is understandably quite confused. You said you knew my brother. What got under his skin? What made him tick?
That's it? That's all you have?
Well, I suppose I don't have any legal evidence. I just find it a little odd how a no-name drug dealer was able to kill 10 drug addicts, 2 police officers, and a variety of other witnesses in a 2-year period. And the police? Well, they were none the wiser, were they?
Sorry to disappoint, but the white-faced killer never supposed to be my case.
Well, it wrapped up quite quickly once you got on it, right?
You know, you've made quite a name for yourself, Mike.
Mike Hudson. serial killer slayer. You put an end to their reign of terror, but they never lived to stand trial. Why do you think that is? 5 men dead. But your body count is much higher than that.
This is ridiculous.
Including my brother Steve. So I must say, it has been quite the pleasure to meet you, Officer Hudson. Or should I say, the Silent Stalker? No, that can't be mine. How about the Whiteface Killer? Or, what was the other one? Was it
the Grinning Man?
What?
You haven't heard? He's back. Don't worry, though. They put me on the case, so you can rest assured the Grinning Man will be put down soon.
Yes. Another ghost story?
No. I'm not one for superstition. This is real. The kid was hacked to death at the old Cooley printing press. Prominent theory that it's some kind of copycat, but I don't think so. Wouldn't it be interesting if that Fogleboch kid was innocent and the real Grinning Man's been out there all this time?
That's a nice little theory you have there, Officer Hudson.
Isn't it? You're the police officer. I think I need to ask you. Where were you last night?
Well, if you must know, officer, I was at my club. My friend Cedric here can account for that.
Either way, I think we'll be in touch.
I think we will.
And I think it's time for you to leave.
Goodbye, Mike.
You have a good one, officer. I'll be seeing you.
Hello?
On the Grinning Man case?
How did you know about that?
I know everything.
Like Hudson?
Yeah.
My name's Wayne Truman. I was an officer in your precinct back in the day.
You're Wayne Truman?
I am.
People downtown talk about you like you're some kind of living legend.
Well, I've heard quite a few good things about you too, Officer Hudson.
Please, just call me Mike. Hey, you care if I walk with you for a bit? I'm actually gonna have my ass if they find out I got kicked out of this place early.
Yeah, it'd be my pleasure. You know, I've been following your career since I left the force. If I'm not mistaken, you've taken down nearly a half a dozen killers now.
I don't like to keep track. It's not pleasant business. So, Mr. Truman, if you don't mind me asking, what brings you here today?
Actually, visiting the old lady. It's her anniversary, and I figure I'd drop off a bouquet of some of her favorite flowers.
My condolences.
Thank you. And if you don't mind my asking, what brings you here?
Well, Joseph Grant's brother is the final victim of a criminal I just put down.
Yeah, the Whiteface Killer.
Yeah.
So, did Grant offer you an exclusive lifetime membership to his club?
No, if I want one of those, I'm gonna have to pay like everybody else.
Cheap bastard.
Do you believe in fate, Mr. Truman?
Why? What's up?
I just got put in a case I think you might be interested in. The original was near the end of your tenure, but I think you can still help. The Grinning Man's back.
You know, it's funny you should mention that. I just accepted a case to find the identity of the new Grinning Man.
That's right. You're a PI now.
Sure am. Here. Why don't you give me a call sometime soon? We'll do lunch. See if we can't crack a few new leads on this one.
You know, I'm actually free right now. What do you say? Should we start this thing so we can be done with it?
Yeah, I'm down.
I'll get in my car and follow you out.
All right. See you in a bit.
There, I'm back. Claire, you okay?
Yeah, of course.
All right. I'd like to introduce you to Officer Mike Hudson. He's going to be working on the Grinning Man case with us, and hopefully we can help him apprehend the killer sooner rather than later.
Pleasure to meet you, Officer Hudson.
Please. Call me Mike.
So, what do you got for us, Mike?
Well, unfortunately, I can't get any evidence out of the locket for you just yet. But I can tell you the handwriting on the note found on the victim's body, eerily similar to the original. Method of murder matches up pretty closely, too.
What are you saying?
What I'm saying is, there's a chance, a small chance, but a chance, that might be the original Grinning Man.
Fogleboch might be innocent?
I don't know, but we can't rule anything out. Why are you two on this case, anyway? You have to have a client, right?
Yeah, Miss Fogleboch. We were hired to find evidence to clear her son's name.
That's awfully convenient. Do you ever consider her a suspect?
No, she's a junkie. All strung out. Probably couldn't even spell her name right if you asked her to. Now, we can put her on the list of suspects, but right now she seems pretty low priority.
Well, you two are clearly further along in the case than I am. How about I go out, find us some new leads? You two stay here, put together a list for me?
And find a connection leads us right where we need to be.
Exactly what I'm thinking.
Okay, then.
Let's find ourselves a killer.
I'll be in touch.
Well, you were pretty quiet just there. It's not like you.
It's just good to see you happy again. It's been a while. Glad to finally meet the man himself.
It's the way he carries himself. The stories they tell about him. He reminds me of myself. Back in the old days. And what he did for Natalie.
I know. You better help loosen him up, though. He gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Yeah, he'll get there. It's hard to keep a poker face with me. He'll come around.
Ready to go?
Yeah, man. All
right.
Hey, Mike.
Hey.
So I heard Chief put you on the copycat case with me?
Unfortunately. Thought I was done with all this, but Chief says I have to suffer like the rest of them.
With an attitude like that, I'd say you haven't suffered nearly enough.
Yeah. But hey, we were just going to go down to Sally's Diner, go over the nitty-gritty about the case. You want to come with?
Yeah, I can do that. Shit. Hey, I forgot. Today's Jade's dance recital. Can you handle this without me?
All right. See ya.
It's a weird dude, man.
Yeah, no kidding.
It's obvious what he's going for, but he has nothing.
Hey, boss, what's with the laptop?
Clancy, I'll cut you.
Sorry, boss. Miss White called. She wants to meet you again for dinner.
Tell her I'd love to.
All right.
Cedric, how's your visit to Mike's hometown going?
Good. I've been talking to some folks. Did you know our friend Hudson had an instance of police brutality, which led to him moving in the first place?
Is that so?
Yeah. And guess who he beat up on? A junkie.
He really seems to have a problem with the druggies.
Certainly seems to. He started this whole hero thing when he moved to Erie. Maybe his boss just wanted to ignore his past.
Good to hear. Keep up the good work, old friend.
Alright, I'll be in touch.
Clancy, I think this hero cop might not be the godsend EPD was hoping for. In fact, I think what we have here is the case of a psychopath in a badge and victims in silly costumes.
Doesn't that sound familiar?
Well, there's a new Grinning Man in town now. And I've got plans for this one.
Why don't we deal with this in the usual way?
No, he's the lead investigator on the case. We can't just kill him. A
as fun as that sounds.
Send Nico to track him. Mike let some interesting information slip today. And I think I know what I'm gonna do with it.
I've got 100, but you gotta come back to the crib with me.
I can't do that.
Okay, 150.
Somebody's up early.
Never left.
Come again?
I was working on this.
Whole lot of names here.
Let's get to work. So what do you know about the Grinning Man?
Look, I just read what was on the teleprompter. I know about as much as you.
I don't know. He's my neighbor. Never seemed too remarkable to me. Guy's got any more beer?
This is gonna take a while, isn't it?
Yeah, what the school with that guy asked. It's really been messing me up. I mean, what if I'm next?
Oh my god, a guy's dead and you're seriously making this about yourself?
For once, can you not be a fucking nightmare?
Oh, now here we go again with you feeling sorry for yourself.
Yeah, so he's back, right? That's so scary. I actually dated that guy he killed back at the printing press back in high school, but he cheated on me, so like, bye. Maybe he'll get one of my other exes
okay.
too. Like, maybe he'll just like kill Jacob
yep.
or something.
I mean, I used to sell Liam weed.
Yeah, that really doesn't help us.
Oh. I thought you wanted to buy some. I mean, my new strain is called Grinning Man.
Well, that's pretty fucked up.
Yeah, we were friends as kids, but I got a hot new mixtape coming out right now. I'm finna blow up right now. Anyway, you single?
All right.
What about the ghost, man? Isn't that place supposed to be haunted?
You know, what if he was right? What if we should be exploring this whole haunted house angle?
That's just an urban legend people say to scare each other.
Yeah, but it might give Maryanne some peace of mind. Know that her son's not a vengeful spirit haunting the world of the living for the past 5 years.
How'd that rumor even start, anyway?
Well, after Fogleboch died,
the new tenant wound up going missing a few days after he moved in.
I do remember reading that. Aren't we meeting up with one of his friends later or something?
Sure are.
I don't know, though. I don't really want to get my boyfriend involved.
Wouldn't be like that. I was on the force back when they first interviewed him about all this. He had an airtight alibi. And besides, he sold the apartment to a rental property place shortly after everything happened. And I did some investigating and a new tenant moved in a few days back. I think we should go check it out. So how's it been over the past couple of days living here?
Notice anything supernatural?
No, it's actually been really nice. But hey, I gotta show you something.
No, we're just...
I'm starting a pet grooming business.
Aww.
Of course you are.
Hey, Mike, you busy?
No. Why?
Just looking to follow up on a hunch I had.
Here?
Kinda. Across the street, actually. So, noise complaint call. That letter's here? I've been thinking, who could have made that? I mean, it's not like there's much going on down here.
What are you saying?
I think our caller was the copycat. And I think he called from the abandoned house on the other side of the road. I'm just gonna go down, check things out. Why don't you join me?
No, I just finished. Let me know what you find, though.
All right. Get a hold of you in a bit.
So how's it looking?
Not sure yet. Just wanted to check up on a hunch I had. Plus, Wayne Truman wanted to talk with me about the Grinning Man case, and his headquarters is right down the road.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah. Want to get a bite to eat after?
Yeah, you want to grab some steaks from Nightlights later?
Nah, don't have money for that. How about the Chicken Shack?
Sounds good, man. Give me a call when you're done.
All right. Talk to you soon.
Creepy-ass house.
Erie PD, if anyone's inside, I'd like to talk.
Hello? Hello? This is Officer Symmens. I have a search warrant to search this house!
Wasn't expecting you to think you'd find this place so quickly. Haven't had a chance to clean up, so we're gonna have to make do with what we have. Close to the bone, sweet is the meat. Last slice of Virginia ham is the best that you can eat. Don't talk about my baby, she's slender but she's sweet. Close to the bone and sweeter is the meat.
Hey man, I'm getting hungry. Get back to me soon or I'm going without you. It's about time. I'll be right there. Make me wait. Tell me I don't want to rush. I said I was coming. I'm.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So what now?
Well, I'm thinking why don't you head home for a bit? I'll message you with the address later on and we can meet up then.
Are you sure?
You know, I have been doing this for a couple of years. I think I'll be alright for this last interview.
Alright, see you later.
Truman and White Investigations.
Hello. This is Officer Jason Fritz with the Erie PD. I need to talk to you immediately.
Man, I resigned myself from this case. I advised Hudson to do the same thing, and he doesn't listen to anyone.
I understand. Please, go on.
Listen, Symmens was my best friend. He's one of the best cops that I know, and he couldn't handle this. I know your reputation precedes you and all, but Wayne, it just isn't worth it, man. Everyone that gets involved with this case, anyone that chases this guy ends up dead. I can tell you, man, I'm getting my shit together and I'm getting out of here. Now, I advise you to walk away from this one.
Officer Fritz, you know I can't do that. I thank you for what you told me. Is there anything else that you can think of?
I don't want anything to do with this anymore. Nothing to do with this. I'm done. I'm out of here.
Really? The chicken shack? So why are we here and don't say dinner?
Guy called me. He said he had some information about the case. Wanted us to meet him down here. I was expecting him to be here by now, but... Look, there's something I wanted to talk to you about.
What's up?
I want you off this case.
What?
Look, another victim was found. A cop following a lead had his head decapitated and sent to his partner.
Are you serious?
I wouldn't joke about something like that.
I know. Look, why don't we just...
Chicken Man, if you do not back off, I am going to choke you.
I'm the guy who called you. Follow me.
Could these chairs be any more uncomfortable?
I like them that way.
Keep me focused. Want some?
I'm good.
So, your friend went missing a few days after he moved into 251.
Yeah, I literally just said that a couple seconds ago.
Yes, I'm aware. But how does this pertain to our investigation?
I didn't ask you here to help with the investigation. I asked you here to warn you.
Don't worry, we have no intentions of trying to track down the grinning man.
No. Not from this copycat crap. From the landlord.
Jay?
We're calling him Jay now?
Yeah, apparently.
You know him?
They're dating.
Bad idea.
And why is that?
Because. He's a grinning man. At first I thought the house was haunted, but that can't be right. The latest several grinning man deaths happened in that apartment. His apartment. Why is that?
Well, your friend is...
gone. Because he didn't listen to me.
And we're sorry about that and all, but it's not true. The latest victims were nowhere near it.
The copycat isn't the real grinning man. Your boyfriend is.
Wayne, this is ridiculous.
Well, Mr. Fox, it's nice having met you.
Just call me Rob.
Rob?
How do I reach you?
This is good.
Ooh. I like this gold sparkly stuff on here. You know, I was actually thinking of making some business cards of my own. Do you think that if I do, I should get my own gold sparkly stuff? I mean, how much does this cost you? This looks expensive.
Well, that was fun.
I'm getting really sick of these accusations about him. You didn't believe any of that, right?
Claire, you know I don't know the guy personally, but I haven't seen any hard evidence to suggest what Chicken Man said about your boyfriend is true.
Good. I've done some thinking and I'm not going off this case.
You remember I'm your boss, right? I make the final call.
Listen, I get your concern, but you're gonna need help with this.
It's pointless arguing with you, so yeah, fine. However, I reserve the right to kick you off my case anytime I feel like it. Understood?
We'll see.
Hey, I'm actually headed down to Creepy Mike's for a couple of drinks. Wanna come along?
I would, but I actually have plans with Jay tonight.
It's going good, huh?
Yeah, it is. You're gonna come around to him eventually, or at least you're gonna try, because he's a keeper.
Hey, I know I said we wouldn't get him involved. I was hoping you could talk to Jay about the case.
We're not making him a suspect.
No, it's not that. Just maybe get him to say some positive things about the Fogleboch kid. Set up an interview.
If you promise to keep it strictly about Liam.
I promise. I just need something better than the big nothing I'm gonna give to Maryanne tomorrow.
Alright, I'll ask him.
I appreciate that. You two have fun. Don't bother coming in the morning. I gotta do the long walk of shame over to Maryanne, so no reason we should both have to do it. I'll catch up with you later on in the day.
Hey, she's nuts. She'll believe anything you tell her as long as it's positive. And we can make up some leads, so relax.
Yeah, I'll try.
See you later. Have fun with Creepy Mike.
Alright, I'm gonna level with you. When your father, God rest his soul, saw an 18-year-old kid with some inheritance money and a couple of rental properties to his name, and found out he wanted to start his own nightclub when he didn't even know the first thing about, well, running a business or legally being allowed to drink for that matter, I'm sure he wanted to tell me to take a hike. But he didn't. Because he respected vision. And look how far we've come.
Yeah, I see he made the right choice. I mean, it's a Wednesday night at 5 and this place is packed.
It's jazz night. They love their jazz night. Now, I'm a wealthy man, but I'm dreaming big. And this project's gonna require a big investment, so I'm gonna need a partner to go in on this with me. Oh, hey, I gotta take this, alright? I'll be just a minute.
Waiting for you in there.
Look, Jay, I know I already said this, but I'll have the money to you next week.
No, I understand, man. Life happens.
Okay, that's good. Good, thank you.
Yeah, I'll be sure to foot the bill to your next of kin.
What? I mean, yeah.
Jay, don't leave me. You said you'd love me forever.
Look, Christopher. I'm running a business here. Okay, I'll have the money to you next week, okay? I promise. I'm sorry. That's what you've said every week for the last 2 months, you stupid fuck.
Family won't like this.
This could have been so simple, but you didn't take me seriously. Your father never would have...
Well, I'm not my father.
No, no, no.
Well, now you're gonna be a bunch of body parts in a concrete block at the bottom of the lake. All right, boys, I'll try not to hit either of you this time.
Oh, dear Johnny, I'll miss you. The best journey.
Got a little.
Oh. Well, any updates on Nico?
No, he's been a ghost since we tried to get a hold of him yesterday.
Well, he better have a fantastic fucking excuse for ignoring me. And Symmens?
About that, we just got these photos from the station. Apparently the copycat got them.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that's sick! Well, he has style, I'll give him that. Oh well, nothing of value was lost today.
But he was our guy close to Hudson.
Look, I know a guy in special crimes who can do us much better than poor dead Symmens or his buck-toothed cousin fucking idiot partner. But hey, I have a date tonight, so I'm heading out after this meeting. We'll talk more about it tomorrow. Sorry about that. Where were we?
Well, I was just about to sign this check to fund the second location you've been telling me about.
You will not regret this.
Hey, Wayne. Brush your teeth, kiddo. Off the bed. Nap time.
Well-behaved kid you got there.
Yeah, she's been helping out a lot, but they got partial custody.
Nasty divorce, huh?
Don't even get me started. Come on in, Matt.
Nice apron.
Yeah, well, I figured I'd make us some dinner.
Ooh, what'd you make?
Lobster bisque. You know I'm a real fancy sort of guy. Why don't you come in and make yourself comfortable? It should just be a couple minutes.
Nice place you got here.
Thank you.
So, question.
Okay, shoot.
Can I ask you a small favor?
Yeah. Oh, soup's done.
So this old lady hired me and Wayne for a case. I was hoping you could sit down with us for an interview.
So you are investigating me?
No. She thinks her son was framed for being the Grinning Man.
The Grinning Man?
Yeah, superstitious much?
No, I just have a dicey history with that name.
Yeah, I know, but we were hoping that her son's former landlord could say some nice things about him. Maybe help her sleep better at night, you know?
You know, that apartment was a PR nightmare for me. That's why I sold it.
Yeah, I tried to call you last night, but I thought it'd be better to tell you in person.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. It's been a hectic couple weeks.
That's fine, hon. So what do you say?
All right. But no more surprises, okay? There's enough snuff pieces about me in the paper as is.
The J-Man delivers again.
Don't call me that.
What? I think it's cute.
Yeah, I'm sorry about all the apprehension there. A certain Mike Hudson showed up at my brother Steve's viewing. He's the guy that shot the guy that killed my brother. Basically, he told me that I'm a suspect in his Grinning Man case based on my 251 connection.
Are you serious? That's so stupid.
Yeah, I don't trust the guy. He definitely has more skeletons in his closet than he's letting on.
He definitely gives me the creeps.
You know him?
Well, kinda. Wayne brought him around earlier.
Oh, yeah, Wayne. Did he like the steak I brought him?
Yeah, it's good to loosen him up a bit. He has good intentions, but after what happened to Natalie...
Who?
Yeah, it's freaking great. But seriously, man, aren't you worried?
What for?
Well, one of your partners was murdered earlier.
Yeah, but... How do you know about that? Those details aren't public yet.
He was supposed to be meeting with me earlier. Instead, I got a call from Officer Fritz. Keep me in on some of the details.
It was horrible. Head was cut off with a hacksaw. Worst part is that they tell me that he was alive while they did it.
Now, why did he even go there? How did it all happen?
He told me he had a hunch about that abandoned house across the street from that abandoned printing press where the vlogger died. Thought the killer might be holed up there.
So, did he find anything?
Well, he didn't tell us anything before he died, and we checked out the house afterwards. It was all burnt and torn up. We checked the basement and found a generator, but that was smashed too.
And you aren't worried?
I mean, I am, but I have to keep doing my job.
Right, but this isn't just some punk thug that skipped bail that you're hunting down. Aren't you worried about your family? About,
Jade.
Yeah, Jade. This guy's a monster. Aren't you worried that she might actually be in danger?
No, I've studied the original about as much as anyone can, and if this isn't the original, it's a damn good copy. The original never went after kids.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I'm just in an anxious state of mind. Ever since last year and what happened with Natalie. Which is one of the reasons I wanted to thank you.
For what?
Well, I didn't want to get too deep at the cemetery, but I think you're right. I think it is fate.
What finally brought you around?
Working the similar cases, and when I met you, I was at the cemetery grieving Natalie. She was one of the victims of the Whiteface killer. Didn't even fit his MO. Still, son of a bitch wound up taking her out.
It was about a year ago. She must have heard the screams or something. She always wanted to help out. I mean, that's just how she was. Bastard was tracking down some junkie freak. She just got in the way, I guess. But still, thank you for letting Natalie rest. Here's to Natalie.
To Natalie! Well, on a slightly less somber news, you found anything on this case?
Nothing I'd really call substantial. Other than some greasy kid that told me he thinks the nightclub guy might be the Grinning Man.
Well, that greasy kid might be onto something. He's on my list, too.
Yeah. Wait, you're serious?
Yeah.
Shit. I gotta go.
You alright?
Not exactly. Claire's over at his place right now. I gotta see if I can get a hold of her. I'll see you later.
Can you turn off the light?
I'm sorry about getting you involved in this. I normally wouldn't have. I just felt so strange lately. Mm-hmm. I just feel like everything's crashing down on me all at once. Like everything.
What do you mean?
The Grinning Man, his mom, that heroin dealer, my parents.
Whoa, slow down. What about your parents?
It's like there's just been this pressure inside of me my whole life, and there's no release for it.
Let's try to get to the root of the problem.
To be honest, I don't even know where to start.
Well, what does the Grinning Man have to do with your parents?
Did I ever tell you what happened to the man who killed my father?
Hello?
You've been activated. Follow your instructions. And if you remove your tracker, you're dead.
You know you can stay here if you want.
I know, I just need to process some stuff. I'll call you first thing tomorrow.
Okay. Just know that I'll always be here for you, okay?
I know, baby. Thank you.
Not gonna lie, not a day goes by that I don't imagine wrapping my hands around his throat and killing him just like he did to my mom.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, I said I was gonna be with Jay, remember? I had my phone off. He said he's down for us to interview him tomorrow.
Yeah, about that. I don't think it's a good idea for you to keep seeing that guy.
Is this about Mike? Screw him, he has no idea what he's talking about. He would never hurt anyone.
Look, I'm not trying to dad you right now. Just be careful.
I always am. You gotta stop with all this.
Stop what? Claire, I'm never going to stop looking out for you.
Talk to you tomorrow.
Hey, property rules says we're not allowed to start fires. gonna swing that axe at me as soon as I move. Inside for a bit. No doubt we'll be talking to the cops all night.
I'll call them now.
I called Jay and he came right away.
And you trusted him after one of his guys tried to murder you?
It's almost like you are begging for something to happen. Why are you intentionally trying to put yourself in harm's way?
Oh, I'm sorry that my judgment wasn't up to your standards after I almost died.
Claire, you had to kill a man last night. That is not something that just goes away.
What?
It haunts you. It just...
I don't regret it one bit.
What?
Well, for one, he tried to kill me.
I'd do it 1,000 times over if I had to.
I'm bringing Mike along to the interview tonight.
Absolutely not.
We need him. And if Jay's innocent, he'll let it drop.
I know he will.
Don't you see what's happening? Mike's got some sort of misplaced vendetta against Jay, and you're eating it right out of his hand.
And you are literally getting into bed with one of our top suspects.
You know, you...
That is none of your business.
You're not my father, I'm not a teenager, so give it a rest. You always do this.
That's enough, Claire. You know, you may think you have it all figured out, but I...
Have my best interest in mind? Get your head out of your own ass.
I just don't want to lose you.
Not like I lost her.
Something?
Evidence.
Oh. You don't trust our forensics team?
I never said that. But unless you think it's a bad idea to have a second set of eyes on this, I'm gonna keep going.
Sure.
Who am I talking to anyways?
Oh, pardon me. The name is Monroe, Special Crimes Unit. I'm your new partner in this case.
Ugh. Hear what happened to the other two on the case?
Yes. Symmens is ahead. And Officer Fritz put a bullet in his mouth last night.
Yeah, they're both good men, I knew him well. But Symmens, he was always too good at getting himself into trouble. And Fritz never had what it took for this job. He was too weak.
It's almost like there's a curse on the position of my cousin's partner. Even your last partner, Griggs.
Look, don't buy into superstition. Good cops don't believe in ghost stories.
Right.
So are there any leads so far?
I have more than a lead. I have a prime suspect, Joseph Grant.
That might be a very hard pill to swallow if true. Did you think it might be one of our own?
Yeah, I had the same thought pretty early on. So I went digging, looked at schedules, see you the day off when the murder happened. Nothing. Everyone's either at the station, out on patrol, or home with their families. They all have alibis.
I'm just saying, it makes sense. The style of handwriting, the design of the mask, the vulnerable position that Symmens was in when he was attacked. I mean, unless it's not dumb luck or superstition, it actually adds up when you stop to think about it.
Yeah, you're right. It is worth going over again. Why don't we meet up soon? We can discuss our leads, see if we can come up with something.
Sounds like a plan to me.
I'll be seeing you then.
What do you got for me?
It seems like he was looking for something. Do you have any idea what it could be?
Yes, actually. I had to deactivate it, but... I picked up a little memento from the crime scene yesterday. Seems to be some sort of a tracker.
Do you want me to send someone to pick it up?
No, it has to be you. I don't want anyone close to Hudson getting their hands on it.
All right, I'll be down to pick it up later tonight.
Sounds good. See you soon.
Hey,
no,
how's
thanks.
It? Is Wayne here?
Let me check.
Wayne, you here? He's not here.
What's up with you? Hey, what's up with you?
Good question. Maybe it's last night's minor incident, or the fact that you're most likely going to accuse me of dating a serial killer.
The copycat was one of his goons. What about the second one?
How did you?
I watched the news.
The press was told they couldn't release any names yet.
It wasn't very hard to figure out.
Congratulations. And what did you want?
To warn you. That second grinning man, what did he look like?
Not tall and skinny if you're implying who I think you're implying.
Is he a little bit bigger? You know, bulky frame?
Yeah.
Like Jay's right-hand man. What was his name again?
Cedric.
Shady guy. You know, I always got the vibe that Jay sent him to do his dirty work after his Grinning Man days. Or at least some of it. You know my theory makes sense.
You're on thin ice.
Are you familiar with the case of Aria Alexander?
Of course. She pulled a gun on the Grinning Man. Couldn't handle not being on top and he killed himself.
See, I thought that too. Until something happened last year.
Go on.
She was murdered.
And what the hell does that have to do with Cedric?
You're not going to believe it from me. Just do the research yourself. The facts are all out there. They're not hard to find.
What am I going to find?
Hopefully. Something that'll get you closer to the truth.
I'll get around to it.
Yeah. Look. I know you don't know me. And I know you don't care about what I have to say, but the facts are there, so at least do me the courtesy of looking for them because I'm tired of people turning up dead everywhere I look.
So why aren't you doing something about it?
I'm trying to. Hey, what you had to do last night? You okay?
I'm fine.
You're dressed a bit snazzy for an interview.
Gotta keep up appearances. Someone should be out any second to let us in.
Mr. Grant will be with you two momentarily. And about what happened last night, I'm sorry you had to go through that.
Oh, it's okay. Haven't really thought about it.
All right. Would you two be okay to hang out here?
Yeah, we'll be fine. We need to talk. Thank you. Claire, I need to apologize to you in advance.
For what?
Sorry to keep you waiting. You'll have to excuse me. I got caught up at the station.
You did not.
Sorry, Hudson. You're not on the list.
Don't have to be. I have a warrant to search the place.
Hey boss, your guests are here, and they brought a friend.
Wasn't invited.
That doesn't matter anymore.
Listen, buddy, this isn't your show.
Really? Because one of his employees attacked you last night, so I think that does make it the police's show now. Mike, I'm sorry, Wayne, but this is police business now. I'm gonna have to take it from here.
Ah, yes. Hero cop Mike Hudson here to ruin another investigation. Look, I know what angle you're going for, and I'm not speaking a word to you without my lawyer present. So kindly help yourself out so I can speak to the people who actually came to talk to me.
What the hell did I tell you?
His guy tried to kill you last night.
So you're gonna tell me that Jay ordered a hit on his own girlfriend?
Whether or not he did, I think Wayne just laid out exactly why I need to be here. And honestly, Jay, I don't care whether or not you talked to me. Her eyewitness testimony places a second grinning man at the scene of the crime. And can one of you remind me who showed up right after the crime happened in order to comfort her?
So, I saw the guy's build. He was a lot bigger than him.
What? Do you look more like his right-hand man, Cedric?
No, he wasn't that big.
Are you sure about that? You said it yourself. The guy was pretty far away. Where is the big man today, anyways?
He's actually doing some investigating of his own.
How convenient.
Yes, very convenient. Investigating in your hometown, nonetheless. The same town you were fired from for police brutality.
What?
Oh, yeah. Police brutality against junkies. Come to think of it, wasn't your last case involving a killer who went after drug users? Drug users like my brother, Steve.
That might be the most obvious deflection that I've ever seen. But if you must know, there's nothing to investigate. My darker past is all on record. And unlike you, I spent the rest of my career making up for it. Claire, Wayne, you can't trust this guy. It's obvious what he's up to.
Why don't you educate me on what exactly it is I'm up to, officer?
It's pretty clear you're involved in the copycat case. Maybe even the original. It's interesting how much of the Grinning Man's history leads to you. The first Grinning Man is one of your tenants. The second one is one of your employees. And the third Grinning Man has a profile suspiciously similar to one of your other goons, who just so happens to not be here today.
It wasn't him.
Then who was it? Who else could it possibly be?
What about you?
Do you have anything to back that up? Of course you don't. The idea is laughable. Soon, I'm gonna have enough evidence to put you away. And when I do, I'm gonna make it my personal mission to make sure you don't spend a day outside of a cell for the rest of your life. I've said my piece.
Great. Now I'll say mine. Would you care to inform us how a tracker ended up on our friend Nico's shirt last night?
What?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh yeah, I saw it. And I don't chip my employees. You can ask any one of them. I also find it a little strange that you refuse to mention the fact that our third Grinning Man's build also seems to match your own. Or how about the fact that you've taken down 5 killers, yet every single one of them has ended up 6 feet underground so they can't talk about it.
Firstly, even assuming everything you said is true, why should anyone believe that I was the one who bugged your employee? And secondly, you conveniently forgot to mention that several of those killers shot me. What? Did I do that myself too?
Oh yeah, they shot you. But never anywhere serious. You didn't even get shot in your last case. But somebody did. I know you killed my brother Mike. And I'm going to make sure that you regret ever even trying to step into my world.
Look at you. You're lashing out because you're desperate. I'm not even gonna justify that one with a response.
I saw the tracker, Mike. And I had a nice little phone call with a certain Officer Monroe today. I believe you know him? I told him everything I saw last night. What? Why are you looking at me like that? Could it be that you know the walls are closing in?
Jeez, Mike, this is pretty serious. If they test that tracker for fingerprints and your DNA is on it, well...
So what? You're admitting to tampering with evidence now.
What, me? Never.
Well, that's good, because that alone would be enough to put you away for a long time. Good talk. Too bad that lawyer of yours couldn't be here for it, though.
That did not go as I...
Get the hell out of here.
What are you...
Leave!
You should probably do the same.
Are you serious? I hope you're happy with yourself. I had one good thing going for me and you just had to ruin it, didn't you?
Claire, this guy could be dangerous. What's this bullshit with the tracker? Maybe he did put a tracker on his own guy.
Are you an idiot? Why would he bring that up and risk implicating himself?
Look, I don't know. Maybe he just...
I quit.
What?
Finish the case yourself. I'll be by later tonight to get my stuff.
Claire! I was just trying to protect you.
Looking for someone?
Oh, it's just you. Not a good idea to sneak up on someone like that.
If not someone, something.
Excuse me?
I suppose you're going to deny that this place was swarmed with your guys last night.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I listened in on your entire conversation down at Red Handed earlier. Witness intimidation? Faking a warrant? You are aware that the station would never approve a warrant to search its biggest donor's place of business on just a hunch. There's a lot of weird shit going on around you. How about if you and I take a trip down to the station together and have a nice little talk?
Fuck! Okay. Joseph, I can get his prints in the gun. I can make this all work out. You want to mess with my life? I'll burn yours to the fucking ground!
So I left the front door open for you.
Well, damn. Mike Hudson at my house so late.
So what are you doing here, Mike?
Find the evidence you need to arrest me? I poured you a drink in celebration. Cheers.
See someone you know, it's like looking in a mirror.
Isn't that shocking?
You know, part of me always knew it was you. You and I are not so different.
I'm not so sure about that.
Oh, I'm pretty sure. I've read all about you. I know the Grinning Man's tricks. I know his limits. And I know his endgame.
Oh, bravo. So you're trying to end it?
Exactly the same way you did it all those years ago. The difference is, you're going to make a much better pin because you deserve it. The police were on my trail, but what better way to throw them off than by bringing back the original Grinning Man?
What can I say? I pay attention!
Don't make this harder than it has to be. I know you're used to being top dog, but this time you just got outplayed. I would love for this game to go on a bit longer. But you just had to take my tracker and mention it in front of witnesses. Now I'm going to have to hold myself over for a while.
Coward. Can't follow through.
Insults are just going to make it worse. In the end, the only question is whether or not you face your death with dignity. Your brother had the same choice. He was shocked at first, but he eventually made the right one. What about you? If it makes you feel any better, The world's gonna remember you. And they will remember you for exactly what you were.
Claire. Hey, I'm sorry. I was just trying to protect you. Look, I didn't know that Mike was going to...
I really don't want to hear it.
I couldn't live with myself if something actually happened to you.
Something did happen to me. You always get in the way because you don't know the full story, and it's really starting to ruin my life. So I can't do this anymore.
You know what? You're right. I don't know the full story, but neither do you. I get you just want to be easy, but you have your doubts. I know you do, because you're smart. So stop ignoring your intuition. This isn't about some guy that might break your heart or cheat on you. This is life and death, Claire. If you make the wrong decisions, you will fucking die. So get your shit together and think before you do.
I always let you walk all over me. Not this time, Wayne. I'm done.
Listen to yourself. You're being hysterical.
This has been a long time coming.
Claire.
Goodbye, Wayne.
We need to go now.
Babe, what's wrong?
It's Mike. He showed up at my house and tried to kill me. I bought some time, but I think he's coming for you guys next. So we need to go now.
What are you talking about?
You lying son of a bitch.
What?
I'll bet Mike found the evidence he was looking for, didn't he?
What? No!
What, am I wrong? It was his guy, Claire. His guy. And you know why he sent him? It's because we were getting too close. Don't you see? It's been him all along. And we were gonna be the ones to put him away.
Wayne.
Don't be an idiot. This is about Mike's tracker that was on Nico's back. I have it on me. I was gonna use it for fingerprints.
Enough of the fucking lies! Claire, move.
Let's all just calm down.
Claire, I need you to move out of the way. This has to end.
No, Wayne, you need to calm down!
Claire! Just fucking listen to me! Mike, thank God. Take him away.
Wayne!
No, don't. Mike! Enough out of you. Now then,
where's my tracker?
You were right about him.
Right about everything.
The Grinning Man isn't the first mask I've worn. It's certainly not gonna be.
Well, I guess it doesn't matter much at this point, does it? What? Him? I wouldn't worry too much about him. I'll reunite him with his wife real soon.
Why aren't you doing this?
Think. None of this had to happen if your boyfriend could have kept quiet about the tracker. We could have solved the case and gone on our merry ways. Oh, well.
Killing the PIs. That's gonna look pretty bad on you, Mike. How are you gonna spin that?
I don't know what you're talking about. I was with these two when you came in and gunned up the place. You killed these two PIs.
I'm so sorry, baby.
So am I.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I still have bullets left.
Claire, grab his gun!
I'll see you in hell!
Don't like it when the tables are turned?
He's not gonna make it far.
No. How do we know he's not gonna crawl out of a corner and stick a knife in my neck when I'm not looking?
Oh.
Oh, how the mighty have fallen.
You already got what you wanted. Just let me die.
Poor sad little dead man. I'd say it's time for sweet revenge, wouldn't you?
Nice mask. Just do it.
Don't have to tell me twice.
You should probably answer that.
Kid.
Two kids.
Yeah, partial custody on one.
Still fighting for the other.
Hello. Yeah, Daddy's here.
Mike let some interesting information slip today. And I think I know what I'm gonna do with it.
Take the ridiculous thing off. If you do exactly what I say, your daughter gets to live.
The grinning man never hurt kids.
Well, he does now.
Guess you really didn't have me figured out, huh?
Rest assured, this new green man will be put down soon.
And that's where I am. Honestly, this has really led me to finding healthier ways to deal with my stress. Unfortunately for Mike's daughter, I can't say the same. Apparently, trying to kill us wasn't enough. Story is he showed up at his ex-wife's house and killed her right in front of the poor girl. Or at least a policeman in a scary mask, as she described it did. Guess he must have had a change of heart about the whole thing and let her go. That's when he showed up to HQ. And in an act of what the station described as remarkable charity, Jay paid for Mike's funeral. He said the EPD shouldn't have to pay the possession of a cop killer, and Cedric came back to town too. Maryanne didn't take the news that the copycat had nothing to do with her son too well, though. But hey, still got that payday. I wonder what Wayne's doing with his. But in spite of everything that happened, something still felt off to me.
A lot of nerve, bitch!
Let's just settle down here.
You don't tell me what the fuck to do! You must be looking for trouble waltzing into my fucking house! What? Can't you speak?
Oh my god!
Bitch!
Come on, try me. Give me a reason, I'm begging you.
Please, stop.
You think this is the first time I've had a gun in my face?
No, but it's gonna be the last time if you don't shut up. You really don't know where you know me from, do you? Think real hard.
I'll go right to the cops with this. I don't care about snitching. You're fucking finished.
Oh, I don't think so. Got this little gem of you last night while I was trailing you.
You're a crazy bitch!
That's right. You should probably take your boyfriend to the ER. He's gonna bleed out soon. Yeah, that fixed it.
Hello?
It's Rob.
How the hell did you get this number?
You gave me your business card, remember? The one with the gold sparkly stuff on it? I need to talk to you right now. Cooling printing press. It's debrief time.
Yeah, give me about 15 minutes.
Oh.
cops turned the power back on, I guess. The first ever Grinning Man victims were found at this location.
I was actually kind of the one that put this place on the map.
You know, man, I'm about done humoring you. You want to tell me why the hell we're here?
They're setting the place up to be demolished. I guess I just wanted one last look at the place.
You know, I thought I had this all figured out. But I had no idea how deep this rabbit hole went. All that time, sitting back, drinking with a guy, laughing it up. And all the while, it was that son of a bitch, Mike Hudson, that killed my wife.
Look, I'm sorry, but there's no way you could have known. But was this really a rabbit hole? Or does it just look like one?
What the... What the hell are you talking about?
How are you feeling on that, by the way?
Stitches are doing fine. What were you saying?
I have a confession to make. Liam Fogleboch. I knew him.
What?
I knew him well enough to know, even that night, that he was innocent. I was actually with Arya that night.
Arya Alexander.
Yeah. They were dating. They got into a huge fight that night because she was cheating on him. With me. Later that night, Arya became the first person ever to survive a Grinning Man attack. And as for Liam, well, she had no problem confirming police suspicions at the time, but she came to regret that just a little too late.
Look, man, are you sure you're just not really bad at reading people? I mean, you had Jay pegged from the start on this.
Let me get to that.
Come on, man. Starting to lose my patience here.
First, Mike Hudson.
So it's been
hot
how
long a week? Tell me about it. So, how you holding up?
Better.
Well, for starters, how do we even know Mike really was a murderer? What if this was just a setup from the beginning?
Nah. It's not possible. He was pulling this stuff long before moving here.
That's right. Well, sure was on top of things here. Even used one of Chase's guys as a pawn. But do you really think he gave up on you that easy?
He had nothing left to lose.
Or everything.
So I've been thinking about this old news story a lot lately. Can't wrap my head around it. This Arya Alexander girl.
So, her brake lines were cut. And her ex-boyfriend,
he got fried.
Shit.
But here's the weird part. Everyone at the scene places another suspicious figure there.
Who could that be?
His face was covered, but his stature matches someone we know.
Go on.
Cedric's.
Now that is weird.
So, this tracker, Jay not only took it without telling either of you, but he brought it with him to HQ when he was supposedly trying to escape with you?
Son of a bitch.
So why didn't you mention the tracker to me?
I was gonna send it to a forensics guy, I know. Prove that Mike's fingerprints were on it. I didn't want to risk you telling Wayne and then getting back to Mike.
Okay, but why did you bring it last night?
Now that is a good question.
He didn't even have to bring it last night. Mike knew where HQ was. And when Claire was brutalizing the guy, why did it take you,
who was in much worse shape than him, might I add, to stop? Why didn't Jay do it?
Please tell me you're not saying what I think you are.
One more thing.
You're responsible for the deaths of two completely innocent people.
I am responsible for the deaths of a lot of innocent people.
I know. Part of me always has, but I didn't care. But tell me. Why'd you take a bullet for me?
Because I love you.
I love you too.
The description Arya gave to the police,
It didn't even match Liam's figure. But the police were so eager to close the case, they took it, buried it deep, and forgot about it. But I found it.
So, what now?
I don't know.
Slender physique. Black suit. And bright red gloves.
Fuck! Come on!
Tell me it hasn't always been there. Tell me you haven't felt that way since the night your father died. Tell me the pressure you've felt this entire time has been unrelated. Or be free. Stop lying to yourself. You know, Mike told me and him were the same, but I know that's not true because I know you and me are the same. So you are going to tell me the truth because that's what people who love each other do. Because you owe me. So tell me, how did it feel?
Beautiful.
Time.